Are you having any issues when signing up for Twitch Affiliates program? Well, this video's for you then. Stay tuned. Welcome to Live Streaming Tech, where you learn to stream like a pro from technology you should know. Here shortly, my brother Dale is going to show you some of the workarounds for problems that people have been having when signing up for the Twitch Affiliates program. Because Lord knows, you've worked your tail off to check all those boxes and get that notification from Twitch saying, hooray, you are now a Twitch affiliate. But that's when problems arise, when people start filling out those forms. Well, take it away, Dale. Show them how it's done.
Since launching the Twitch affiliate setup video over on my Self-Publishing with Dale channel, I've discovered there has been many issues when it comes to the Twitch affiliate setup process. And so I want to address some of the common concerns and issues that I've run into since releasing this video. No way to select payment method in step 4. This seems to be something new that's been rolling out over the past half year or so. The setup process is starting to exclude the payment method to later on after the actual approval process. So what I would say is just give it about 1 to 3 days for them to approve everything, and then you can always come back in and address the payment method that you want to use. Keep in mind that you can always go back later on too and change out your payment method because you may have a different bank account or you may want to use a different processing method. No immediate affiliate access. Much like I said in the previous issue, you're gonna have to probably wait it out about 1 to 3 days. And I've found that sometimes, according to some people, they say that they're not even sending out emails to let you know that you have been approved. They're just giving approval and not saying a single thing. So just check in on your dashboard from time to time and you'll know once when you're able to upload emotes and sub badges that you have been officially approved. Do I need a social security number? Yes. In fact, if you don't use a social security number or a tax ID number of some sort, you need to use an EIN or an employer identification number that you can get assigned to you through the IRS. Now, if you happen to be between the ages of 13 and 18, you must get parental consent to use your social security number because Twitch is not ready to take on that liability. They want to make sure that you are actually getting permission to use this on their platform. If you're still getting issues getting parental consent, you're going to probably need to, first of all, tell them a few things that they may need to know. Twitch is owned by Amazon. Amazon is a veritable online juggernaut and an unstoppable force. So they're not going to be investing their hard-earned time or money into this platform if it's, for some reason, a scam or not something worth pursuing. In fact, actually a handful of years ago, they actually invested in Twitch a near $1 billion. So this just goes to show that Amazon really believes in the Twitch platform and what it's going to produce in the coming years. And if they're really concerned, they're like, oh gosh, I don't want to put your social security number or any kind of tax information in here. It is a secure site that is owned by Amazon. Again, Amazon wants to make sure that they protect their assets as well as yours. So this is going to be important to them, and I'm sure it's going to be important to your parents if you're looking for that parental consent. And if you're still worried about setting up something through Twitch because maybe they're going to charge you, you don't have to pay Twitch anything to be a Twitch affiliate or partner. So relax, everything's gonna be okay. Worst case scenario, let's just say your parents are like, well, let's just go ahead, we're gonna do it on a trial basis. The nice thing is they can try something like this out. And in the event that they're kind of like, nope, never mind, don't wanna do it, you can still delete your account or shut it down altogether. Fair warning. You do need that tax information all filled out in order to become an affiliate or partner. They're not just gonna blindly send money over to people because obviously it's owned by Amazon, so they have to report everywhere they're spending money or sending money to people that are earning off of their platform. So you still must report any earnings that you have as taxable income. Now, I'm not a tax expert, so you're gonna need to get a hold of a qualified CPA to get all of that information all dialed in according to what you're doing. Now, these next two specific issues are the most common ones, so you're gonna wanna make sure you pay really close attention and stick around to the end because I'm gonna have an extra tip that's gonna level up your Twitch affiliate status. Tax interview mismatch. This one has people pulling their hair out. They're going in, they're filling out their address, or they're filling out your name and their address, and it's saying that there is a mismatch. Well, here's the deal. You're going to need to, first of all, shut off autofill. If you use autofill, say through your Chrome browser or elsewhere, you're going to need to shut that off and painstakingly type every last keystroke and make sure that they match up exactly the same. This includes capital letters, any type of punctuation, be it dashes or periods, and even spaces. So if you've got a couple extra spaces on one line and not on the next, then it's going to have a tax interview mismatch. Royalty tax interview form won't load, or it shows a blank window. Okay, this is by far the most common issue I've run into when it comes to filling out the Twitch affiliate form. So here are a few solutions. It may work, it may not work, but I'm gonna go ahead and get you some good contact information should it not work. Let's start it out. First of all, pop-up blocker. You probably have a pop-up blocker on your browser, so you're going to need to disable that just for right now while you fix this tax interview form. As soon as you shut it off inside your browser, you're going to probably have to refresh and go back through the process again. Clear your browser cache. This is going to vary from one browser to the next, but you're going to need to clear your entire history on your browser cache so that way it's brand spanking new. Start from the beginning of your royalty tax interview form so that way it goes completely clean into the process. And when all else fails, use a different browser or a different computer altogether. This is a bit of an overkill, but it has worked for some people in desperate situations to where they've done it 30, 40, 50 times and it's still just not providing any kind of results. The royalty tax interview keeps coming up blank and it's just becoming frustrating. I would recommend just use a completely different browser than you ever use or go over into a different computer altogether and try it again. And as a last resort, if for some reason some of these solutions aren't working for you, then you're just gonna have to reach out to Twitch support. And I understand that this is not gonna be as warm and fuzzy as a video like this, but it's really what we've got at this point. So you can head on over to our quick link at livestreamingtech.site/twitch support to get a hold of the Twitch support staff and put in a ticket that you're having some issues. Be very specific about what you're having as far as problems go, because you can see that it varies from one person to the next. And while we're at it, I want to let you know that since you are now going to be approved for Twitch affiliate status, you're going to need to get a good start on your Twitch emote and sub badges. So head on over to our video right over there, and I'll see you then. Four different images. So this is going to give us a little bit of an opportunity to play with some of the masks and such. So we can pull out.